What's up, guys, and welcome back to The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. And today, we're going to be continuing on with the main quest. We got a few spirit orbs in the last episode, though, so that we could get our first heart upgrade. But today, we'll be going ahead and doing our main quest, which should be over here. Locked Mementos, you proved to Cameron... you proved the camera works again by capturing an image of Pura. According to Pura, the album already has pictures from the past in it. Where could these have come from? Impa in Kakariko Village may have the answer. So we're back in Kakariko Village. We're going to be talking to Impa about the photos and sort of see what she has to say about it. Who knows? Bust open these doors. Hello, lady. How you doing? Huh. I heard Pura was giving you the runaround, but you seem just fine. Locked Mementos, complete. How was it? Wait, how did that complete it? Now then, let me see. Here you go. Oh. Oh, that's right in front of the castle. Aha, this is without a doubt the camera that Princess Zelda used 100 years ago. Cool. Hmm. It could be that if you visit the locations within those pictures, you'll be able to restore some of your lost memories. Come back here once you've tried going to at least one of those locations. There's something I wish to give you. Okay, capture Mementos, new objective. I thought I just completed it. Hello, Bayan. Master Link! Is anything the matter? Anything at all? Can I help you in any way? What's that ball? This priceless artifact here? Is that what you want to know about? This is the Sheikah heirloom that we have long protected. The hero as chosen by the Sheikah heirloom will be gifted the blessing of antiquity. With these words as our guide, we have watched over the sacred artifact since my grandmother's time. And ever since her grandmother's time before that. I cannot say that I entirely know the meaning of these words, but now that I think about it, the hero as chosen by the Sheikah heirloom, could it be... Please don't hesitate to let me know if I can ever be of service. It could be me. What's your story? You want to know my story? Well, my name is Paya. The reason I was named Paya is because I have a birthmark shaped like a papaya seed. Why? Well, it's kind of, oh, I think I asked to see it. Master Link, I advise you change the subject. I'll answer you someday, just not today. Please don't hesitate to let me know if I can ever be of service. This village. We Sheikah have long served the royal family of Hyrule in secret. During the great calamity of 100 years ago, the royal family was destroyed and the members of our tribe scattered. Sadly, there were some who allegiance. Okay, this is the Yiga clan. I get that. Master Link, now that you are awake, you are surely the most formidable opponent for staying against them. Know that they will come for you employing whatever underhanded methods they can devise, like eating my soul. All right. The great fairy Koteran. Only a few remain who know this, but this village was built under her watchful eye. The mysterious power of Koteran is that of a sacred protection. I suggest you seek her out. We already found her. The great fairy resides behind the shrine that overlooks this village. That is where you should seek her. You can put your trust in the great fairy. I can't think of any reason she wouldn't be happy to help you, Master Link. Please don't hesitate to let me know if I can ever be of service. We are good. I'm good, thanks. Good luck. What happens if I just try to take it? You're sort of in the way right now. Okay, so I can't. Like, what if I even, like, I can't, like, no, I can't sneak up and take it. It's not like Skyrim. All right, see ya. All right, then, so it's still saying I can talk to you more? If you want a different outcome this time around, you'll need to be properly equipped. Okay, I won't fail. Princess Zelda's fight. Yeah, I know. It's saying I could just go back to her, but I think what I need to do, capture memories, Princess, I need to figure out some more of these memories. So let's try to find some. Is that like my main quest is just to find all 12 of these pictures for now? Here, how do I do that? Album. So there's one of them right here, and this is in front of the Hyrule Castle. This one, I feel like I've been there. Actually, yeah, I could see where that could be nearby, because I know that mountain as well. This one, I know where that like flying airship is, but I've never been near there. This definitely haven't been near. That one's tricky. Also haven't been there, but the castles really help sort of figure out. That looks like it's Cannot delete it. Get rid of this one. Makes me look bad. Ooh, that's cool. Oh, it's just at least showing me some cool stuff in the game. So these are the ones that we found. So yeah, it's really, really weird because our main quest, like that is the only one we can do right now, right? Well, I could do that. Let me try finding at least one photo and then maybe we'll carry on with the Divine Beast related things. I know where to find that first one then. It's just a matter of getting there's gonna be a big old hassle, so we might wanna try that one first. Okay, well if I wanna try that one, I gotta go ahead and teleport around the map a little bit, because that mountain, I think is like right here. So let's, or here. It's hard to tell, no, it's here. Yeah, I'm just sort of getting confused on the map. It's right here, so I need to like teleport here maybe, and let's try to just find the best position. And I think we'll be able to find it without too much of a hassle. Oh yeah, it's right there. So I'm gonna have to like compare. What are some context clues? You have a small mountain and three, almost four birch trees. So let's look for birch trees, because birch trees honestly aren't too common around here. You see these like brown wooden trees a lot, but not birch trees. And it's pretty far in the distance, so. In the picture it is, I mean. And it's on grass. That's another big context clue. So like over here, chances are it won't be here. And it's actually, I think it's actually farther than this. Oh yeah, because you see, but it's also in front of water, correct? It's in front of water. It's in front of water, but there's also some kind of thing in the way, some kind of an building. So we're gonna try to find this one. I think this one, it won't be that bad once we sort of find the good positioning we want. We're at the East Post Ruins right now. Might be able to find a cool chest or something. This is, oh, what is this? This is a rusty halberd. Cool. Hold on. Let's go ahead and beat you up, dude. I don't know with what. I'll go ahead and use this. There you go. Gotcha. I can't use the halberd right now, but it didn't do too much damage anyways, so I'm not too worried about it. Where might be more water? Like what I'm not seeing, and there's another big dude, is a lot of water. I'm seeing a lot of everything else. There's a lot of moblins around here. Like a big old bunch of them. Like I wonder if you ever have to alter to the terrain. But maybe it, that's sort of the thing though, right? That's what it looked like 100 years ago when the photo was taken. What if it doesn't look like that anymore? That's a good question. Because it could be that it could be in a place where there was water, that there's water no longer. But most land formations are likely to stay the same. It's where it's like dead on too. So realistically, it would be around here. But I've yet to find it. It's really odd. I would like to, I might have to take this guy out because I feel like he might actually be standing maybe where it's supposed to be. Like maybe the birch trees aren't even supposed to be there anymore. There we go, we hit him like that. See if I can't hit him one more time when he turns around. There we go, and then I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Throw this at him. And then while he's getting knocked back, I throw another one. That even doesn't like knock him off his feet, which is crazy. Like headshotting him does, which is good. And then I can, ready? Whoa. Oh, I missed. Okay, bad news. Oh, I hit him in his knee. Took him out good. So all you gotta do is hit a man in his knee. This feels almost right. Like, it feels really close to being right. Oh, look at all these deer. So adorable. I gotta look at it one more time then. Because it's also, there's just, I don't know, it's really tough. Like, this is actually tougher than I expected it to be to find that perfect angling. Because I was expecting at least like one thing to, you know, like match up, but like maybe here? Nah, this can't be. I think I'm getting closer. The farther back I go, the more, like it's really huge. So you just like, you don't realize it until you get closer to it, but it's farther from it, I guess. Look, these guys are still hunting you down? These guys have been hunting you down for like weeks. Like, neither of you guys are like, have quitter attitudes. Why is this so laggy? Come on, get out of here. And then get, hold on. What? Yeah, I'm done with you. I am done with you. All right, there's a horn. There's some fangs. We gotta be close. Cause look, like, I think it matches up with the picture quite well. Like, distance-wise. So, like, if I could just find it... I would say it's even farther away. Like, it's crazy how much distance you can get from this thing and still be able to see it. Like, maybe it's even like, ah, ow, buddy, try that again. Try that again, try me. Try me, yeah, I thought so. My sickle broke, though. That was a cool, what is it? Ooh, Octoballoon. Octorok tentacle, this can only be attained by from an Octorok type enemy. It's too acidic for cooking, but it's highly valued as an ingredient for elixirs. Cool. Still haven't found any birch trees. Like, that's gonna be the big pointer. If these birch trees are still here, that's gonna be the big telltale sign. Are these are birch trees over here. I'm pretty sure, look at this. This is a whole setup of birch trees. I've found my spot, ladies and gentlemen. Bada boom, got you good. Bada boom, wait, oh, hold on. Okay, wait, drop, run, explode it. These things are like the most useful thing for combat, by the way. I need to go ahead and get a weapon. Let's go ahead and do this one, sure. What? Oh, I tried to dodge it. It didn't exactly work, not at it. Run, drop. Bada boom. Oh, and he's down. Like, these guys are pretty tough, but they're not as tough as I was always expecting them to be. The Moblin Club, a crudely fashioned club favored by moblins. It's carved from a sturdy tree, but is sloppily made, so it breaks easily. Those sloppy moblins. The problem is that you can't really get the best view of the thing from here. But this has to be it. This has to be. Is there somebody fighting over there? Yeah, they're fighting over there. Here, we'll deal with you in a moment, okay? I got a picture to take. I got a beautiful picture to take. It's gonna be fabuloso once I can find the perfect angling. The perfect picture's gotta have the perfect angling. And I think it's actually gonna be on that side of the road. Okay, we're gonna help these guys then. They're on our way over, we might as well. I don't know if this is like, you know, like a special event, like maybe this might not already be. Let's go, you filth, how about you? What are these guys sound like Skyrim, like warriors. Like they're, how they're like, you never should have come here. There we go, I got it, don't worry. Ladies and gentlemen, I got that too. All right, hi. Funny, I don't remember asking for your help. And now they'll call me the rude one if I don't thank you somehow. Come on, they were red bokoblins. Energizing honeyed apple. You know, I wasn't gonna tell anybody, but you know what? I think you just secretly wanted to give me a gift. Humph, I'll get them next time for sure. Sure thing, lady, sure thing. What about you, dude? Do you have anything to say? Thank Helia that Mina is safe. I knew it wasn't smart to go treasure hunting in these parts. Okay. Riveting. Riveting conversations we're having with these people that apparently don't like us. Rusty broadsword, cool. But it is down from what I currently have, which is, you know, this sword. So I'm just gonna keep what I have. Not gonna change it up. There's a chest in here though. I'll gladly grab that. Like, this area seems to be littered with some cool stuff. It's gonna be having an emblazoned shield. This shield features a traditional design from Nekluda. Its combat capabilities aren't much better than the standard wooden shield, but it's found popularity from its design. I wonder if we could get a pretty penny for that then. Let me go ahead and, if I have two of these, I'm just gonna go ahead and drop one. And just take this. And then we gotta find that perfect angling for that picture. I'm not gonna rest until we do that. Whoa, hey, who's that? Who wants to get beat up? Ah, stop having good aim. Okay, buddy, you want some? No, my bow broke, come on! I get the worst luck. The worst luck all the time. Here, you want some? Come on. He's got a good aim, but I got just as good aim. Oh, I got you good. Nice. I might run over there and get some stuff. I'll go over there soon, I promise, but first off, oh, this is it. This is totally it, look at this. This is it. Where is it? Just recall. Look at this, we did it, we finally found it. Hey, it only took us like 20 minutes. What's gonna happen now? Memory, take a pic. Snap that pic, dude, that's it. Now what? That's it, you remember? What happened here, man? What happened here? Who hurt you? It's funny that it does look exactly the same. Ooh, get a flashback! Oh, look at this! This is so cool!
Here we'll make our way to Goron City. Then, we'll need some adjustments on that divine beast so Daru can manage it as easily as possible. He's figured out how to get it to move. However, it's apparent that we still have much more to learn. But to think, that divine beast was actually built by people. That means we should be able to understand how it works and how to use it to our advantage. These divine beasts, so much we don't know. But if we want to turn back Calamity Ganon, they're our best hope.
Uh-oh. Sad realization.
Tell me the truth. How proficient are you right now, wielding that sword on your back? Legend says that an ancient voice resonates inside it. Can you hear it yet, hero?
I guess not. I think Link didn't answer like every other situation. Oh! I think I left the oven on! It's been 100 years. My gas bill's probably insane. Captured memories. There we go, we updated it. Cool, cool, cool. No, we just gotta do something else. Hyrule's still like a hop, skip, and a jump from here. I might try making my way over just to, I wanted to get more than one memory today, but I also wanted to swim over there and get my stuff if it's still over there. I think it's gone. Looks like it. Okay, we'll try to trek on over to Hyrule and try to get one more memory if we can. I think that'd be good. And then I'll go ahead and move on to some other quests, maybe, you know, start some other things. I'm not really sure. It's like, it's really hard at this point in the game right now to find the proper focus, like what I should be doing in this moment. It's really hard to tell. And that's sort of the thing with this game, is it's so free-flowing. It's sort of supposed to be that way. Now, what is this? I don't know if this is a good idea, because it looks like a little egg. Okay, we're supposed to do it. I'll take it. Yeah, you found me. That's another Korok seed. Bye. They're really not, you know, very explanatory, but maybe that's just how I like. What is up here? Is this a little tree nut? That is an acorn. Nice. Didn't take any fall damage. So we're heading over to Hyrule Castle now, which is nice and good, nice and dandy. And I'll do it again. Spooky heading up to it, I'll tell you that much. Whoa. Here come the keys again. These guys just aren't pleasant. Hold on, hold on, hold on. I'm pretty sure they know I'm here. Oh boy. Wait, throw! I didn't get any of them. Didn't get any of them. Hold on, hold on, hold on. Are they gonna chase me? They are. Go, 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 go. Get a boom! Wow, I got most of them there. Holy cow! I don't know about most of them, but I got a decent amount. There we go. It just feels like not all of them drop something, which is a huge bummer, and then they run away though. That's really the best way to do it. Cause then they can't hit you, and they get scared and they run away. Very cool, it's getting dark and spooky. I found myself a hearty trouble. This rare mushroom has a rich scent. Cook it before eating to temporarily increase your maximum hearts. Really, cool. I gotta get food. Look at these guys bumping into each other, too scared of what's going on. I can fill up 2 hearts here, so I might as well go ahead and maybe eat our last cooked steak. There we go. Like, I don't wanna fight any baddies, but I might actually have to if I get too much closer. I might not actually be able to take this photo. But I could try climbing a tower. If I could climb a tower here, that would be very beneficial. Look at those northern lights. I don't know if they're northern lights, but maybe that's the game telling me I have to do something there of note before I can do anything here. I just wanted to find this, which I think I'm right about to hit. Like you see, it's sort of, it's a little too dark to see. But I think there's like the pillars here, like a pillars right here. Really hard to tell at this angle and this brightness, but I mean, it might not even be on this side. It might be on the other side of the castle, which would not be very helpful for me. Uh-oh. No, 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 ah, no, somebody help me. I'm out of here. Goodbye, I changed my mind. I changed my, see ya. I'm done with, I'm not dealing with him. No, he's a no-go. That is a no-go right there. We're gonna have to find something else to do. Cause I'm not doing that. Lady Impa! I got
information for the quest. Lady Impa. You ain't here. Hey, do you ever sleep? Maybe she just sits here and sleeps. Now that you've seen some of Princess's memories, you must have started to remember certain things. Here, I will hand this over to you now before I forget. Champion's tunic? Ooh la la! In ancient Hyrule, this garment could only be worn by one who had earned the respect of the royal family. Equipping it will reveal an enemy's life gauge. This is something of yours that I have been keeping safe by request of the princess. This clothing was specifically made for you when you became a champion. Please handle it with care. Cool. So I'm gonna go ahead and equip that right now, because it's better than what I currently have on when it comes to, wait, 11? Yeah, this is 11. I guess, I don't know why there's a number here and a number there. I don't know. So now what? You may not remember the last meeting with Ganon, but it did not end well for you. If you want a different outcome this time, you'll need to be properly equipped. Okay. So I don't think there's too much more I can do besides find more memories. Ha, how strange. I think 100 years ago you swore the champion's tunic. You wore the champion's tunic every day. I feel as though I've been transported through time. Link, our princess, you must rescue her. So if I like take a look at my adventure log, like it'll just tell me to go to Impa, but like obviously there's not too much I can do with Impa right now. So I'm gonna go ahead and unequip that, and we're gonna do, I guess, free to divine beasts. Like obviously I think that's our next big focus. What is the closest one when it comes to freeing divine beasts? Like if we zoom way out. There's a few things, like there's this over here, and I just, like, I'm trying to figure out what the best course of action. Maybe I should do some side questing, maybe I shouldn't. It's really weird and hard to decide. Ugh, I'm just gonna try it. I'm gonna try going to that one, and like, maybe I'll be prepared. Like, that's sort of the thing, like this game is super cool that it's free roaming because you can do literally whatever you want, whenever you want. But the problem with that is that you simply don't know when is a good time. Am I prepared for this? Am I not? I'm not really sure. Hello, do you have anything? Yawn, did you bring my ancient materials? Ancient materials! So, which rune do you want to power up? Remote bomb, oh shoot, remote bomb. Remote bomb, power up time, yahoo, for that, I'll need three. Oh yeah, I don't, I'm such an idiot. I wanted to go up here, so we haven't gone up here. Oh, the staircase, it literally does not lead anywhere. I thought it was gonna have a second floor, because she told me that there was stuff on the second floor she was embarrassed about. I guess up here then is more what she means. We'll have to find out. There's a nice little umbrella here. I love this area. It always reminds me of Jak and Daxter. I really like that. So this is somebody's room. Nothing really I can do in this room though. Wait, can I sleep here? I cannot. Interesting. They won't, it's a Mikasa Sukasa, huh? I see how it is. What about in here? There has to be some, ooh, let's see. Research diary of anti-aging rune classified for Pura's eyes only, first page. Date? Huh? Work has finally begun on my anti-aging rune. If all goes to plan, I believe it will effectively reverse the aging process. This technology will enable us to make retired warriors young again, thereby strengthening the Hyrulean army. When Calamity Ganon inevitably returns, we'll be ready. Our defenses, our offense will be solid and our defense impenetrable. The need for this tech pains me, but I truly hope to use it to attain everlasting peace for all. Next page. The beta version of my anti-aging rune is complete. I have already added it to the Sheikah Slate, and I made a sheet I made myself. Since I am able to be the, since I am to be the test subject of this experiment, Simon booted up the rune and directed its rays up at my body. After 20 seconds of exposure, I felt extreme fatigue and broke into a fever, forcing us to cease the experiment. Unable to stay awake, I went to bed immediately. Tomorrow, I will try to figure out what went awry. Next page. Anti-aging experiment trial number day two. My extreme full body fatigue has slightly improved, for which I am grateful. Still, I do not recognize the face in my mirror. My hair is thick again and floor length. My wrinkles, once deep as trenches, have vanished without a trace. It seems the anti-aging effect works. However, I did not expect the reversal to happen so frighteningly fast. This morning, I kicked Simon awake and had him run a full physical exam on me. My height, weight, vision, bone density, heart, and blood. We tested everything we could, pushing our facility to its limit. Our discovery was startling, my results typical of a Sheikah woman in her early 50s. In other words, I reversed my age more than 70 years in a single night. I can only hope I do not awaken to find that I have the body of a newborn baby. Next page. anti-aging experiment trial day 3. I awoke with an abundance of energy. It has been decades since I slept so well. Upon awaking, I immediately checked the mirror, only to be greeted by a youthful version of myself. According to Simon's examinations, I have the body of a Sheikah woman in her 30s. 30 years old. I was around that age when I first was able to continue my research following the Great Calamity. The first thing I did was try to figure out how to expand the functionality of the Sheikah sensor. I was around 80 years old when that expansion was completed. I intend to bequeath this tech to our sleeping hero. Ooh, that's me. I hope to the gods that he will be able to assist the destruction of the calamity that swallowed our Princess Zelda whole. Anti-aging experiment trial day 4. After today's routine physical, the results show that I have a body of a Sheikah woman in her 20s. So it's slowing down a little bit. I haven't felt this good in a century. This is all taking me back to when the Great Calamity happened. Ganon had been dormant for 10,000 years. Perhaps his power had been building all that time. The slaughter of that followed was arbitrary and merciless. The destruction complete. We lost everything. Hyrule Castle, Princess Zelda. Well, perhaps not. Everything was lost. A youth named Link was brought to me 100 years ago, covered in wounds on a death doorstep. Link, so young yet so courageous. He was the youngest knight to have ever been appointed to the Imperial Guard at Hyrule Castle. He was also gifted swordsman who was selected as captain of Princess Zelda's personal guard. I thought his skills would be enough to defeat Ganon in glorious fashion. Since ancient times, the royal family of Hyrule and us Sheikah researchers have had a strong bond. Their pain is our own. We took the swordsman and Sheikah Slate Princess Zelda left behind to the Shrine of Resurrection. Although the Slumber of Restoration had not been fully tested, we decided to put the swordsman under to save his life. It was the best we could do. I want to read like as much as I can. Day 5, I woke to something horrifying. The scarlet jump scarring my otherwise youthful face. After analyzing this monstrosity, I have come to the conclusion that it's just a pimple. A big one. The result of today's physical exam indicate that my body and mind have reverted to those of a teenager. I feel like Simon looks at me differently, which irritates me. I got angry when he insisted on running a blood test for me. I mean, really, what even? I can do it all by myself. In any case, I wonder what experiment I should focus on next, that teenage angst. The blue flame in the furnace outside is growing weaker by the day. I do hope that the guidance stone doesn't stop working. Day 6, my age reversal progress has furthered still. I now look and feel like a 6-year-old. My height has regressed so much that I can no longer reach things in high places. It's super annoying. Where is that genius swordsman we placed in the Slumber of Restoration anyway? Wake up already. If he doesn't awaken soon, my future expansion for the Sheikah Slate sensor will go to waste. But even if he does manage to wake up, how can I be sure he'll find me here? I want to go and just kick my Linky awake, but I doubt Simon would help me. It would be hard with my 6-year-old body anyways. Instead, I think I'll begin working on a rune to unverse my aging process. Anti-aging experiment trial day 7. The morning exam results indicated that I'm still age 6, same as yesterday. Perhaps my age reversal has stopped. As luck would have it, today is also finished. I've also finished up the beta version of an age boosting rune. If successful, this should be able to reverse the effects of my anti-aging rune. I hope it will anyways. All I need to do is increase the output and expose myself to its rays. However, when I tried to add this feature to the Sheikah Slate I made, I found the guidance stone had stopped. What's more, the blue flame in the furnace outside has gone out. I sent Simon to the ancient furnace, but he was too clumsy and it was raining and nothing went to plan. So I had to go down there to help, but a girl in the village saw me. What a mess I've made. Not only am I unable to continue my research in this state, I can only work by the light of gas lamps. What to do? I can't believe it, our hero. Okay, wait. The slumber. Okay, we haven't heard this. I really should have done this test run on that thing first. We'll live and learn. In any case, he got the ancient furnace working, so now I can finally research once again. Finally! Once a truly gifted and heroic swordsman like him have achieved all that. Only. Speaking of, this seems like a good opportunity to get him to do some other chores for me, too. Alright then. That's good. So that's all that there is. It was worth reading that, though. Informationally, I feel like I gathered some things from that. Was there anything else in the room? She has, like, a tiny bed, too. That's cute. Oh, the ladder is for her so that she can reach things. Duh. Okay. Let's open this up and get out of here. And I wanted to go this way, right? Because there's quite a lot of them, as you can see. But this is the closest one. It's a, you know, skip and a jump away. But I'm trying my best to get there. And like, I don't know. Maybe what I should do... Ah, oh, man, I keep changing my ideas, but Sunshroom Sensing, where would that be? Wait, why would it tell me to go back? What? I thought it was telling me to go out here earlier. Oh, come on. All right, so this actually is the forest he was talking about right here. And why aren't you jumping? I'm trying to make him jump and he won't jump. But this thing is supposed to now go crazy when I'm near a sun shroom. So it was saying I was near one right there for a moment. It might have been because I was falling down that mountain. But we just gotta find one. It shouldn't be that big of a deal. And then once we do that, we can see what that'll do for us. But there is this right here. That's an iron shroom. Maybe they're above my head? I'm not exactly sure. It's going off, but I don't really see too many right now. They had to be around somewhere, though. They have to be around. It was freaking out again when I was, like, right here? No? Somewhere? Oh, over here. It was getting really happy over here. I don't know. I don't really like how the sensor works sometimes. Ah, well, in any case, there's one right here. Sun's room. But yeah, it's like I'm right on top of it. It's not freaking out, even though it's supposed to be searching for them, finding new objective. I don't know what it's trying to find, then. Either way, I want to get as many mushrooms as I can right now, just because I feel like it'll be quite helpful to have them. We'll get that, get this, get that, and there's a few over here as well, and they're everywhere. I'm like, really working this forest dry. I hope these things like do respawn. I mean, they did respawn in the back of the building, so I can only assume they will. Because, you know, if not, then I'm extincting a bunch of mushrooms. And there's a bunch of these little guys. Can I get some? Oh, I almost got you. I got you. All right, I think I've got enough of them now. I'll go ahead and I'll teleport back up here. Well, that's not what I wanted. Come on, game. I want to teleport right there, travel up there, and we're gonna go ahead and deliver him some sun shrooms. Okay, let's go. Dude, man, I got stuff for you. Good evening. I see you've brought the sun shrooms. Okay, now please hand over 3 sun shrooms. Sure, no. Get your own, old man. I just wanted to show mine off. Thank you. Here you go. What is he gonna give me? Hearty truffles. So, was the Sheikah sensor to your liking? Oh yes, I just remember that there was something else I wanted to talk to you about. Stop by when you have the time to talk. Right now. Ah. Link, I've got some news about that should be music to your ears. I found a way to help you research new objects using the Sheikah Sensor Plus. Please feel free to show me your excitement. Anyway, as I was conducting my research, I found that there were still some pictures of the past left on the Guidance Stone. If you add those pictures to your Hyrule Compendium, you can search for their subjects with the Sheikah Sensor Plus. Is it hard? Hard? No, not at all. The Sheikah Sensor has been powered up to the Sheikah Sensor Plus. It can now access a picture registered in the Hyrule Compendium, allowing you to search for the subject of the picture. I trust now that you can see the benefit of adding pictures to the Hyrule Compendium. It makes it much easier to search for items you need, reducing one more burden to the face in your travels. I shall explain it once more. I'm good. Now then, go ahead and place your Sheikah Slate on the Guidance Stone. So we're gonna get like a bunch more pictures, I guess. I don't normally like to let people use my Guidance Stone for free, but I kinda wanna see what'll happen, so just this once I'll let it pass. Man, lady, I'm like the hero of everything. Well, you heard her. Could you go and use the Sheikah Slate over there? Sure. Thank you. Let's go ahead and turn on that Guidance Stone. Snap. Okie doke. And here comes another one. So we're gonna get more pictures for this, which will be helpful, if not anything else. Sheikah Slate authenticated, adding picture, okay. Okay, so we got a picture. Hyrule Compendium updated, we got a few pictures of different mushrooms. Nothing crazy, really. Or at least that was in the food section. Should discover it a little bit more and maybe I'll be able to find out. But that's cool, if there is somebody who needs a specific thing, I can try to, you know, find it a little bit easier. All right. See, check it out, dude. Oh, wow, it seems Hyrule Compendium recovered a picture from the past. It appears to be a picture of a Guidance Stone. From the Guidance Stone was transferred, okay. You can't restore transferred pictures, but you can't restore transferred pictures, so be careful of overwriting it. You can fill open slots by taking pictures with the camera or by using the Guidance Stone. Cool. And it won't be free from now on either. Keeping a loud like running this takes expenses, blah, 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 blah. I can't read. Yes, what she said. Cool. You guys waste a lot of my time sometimes. What is he even looking for? I guess the sun shroom still. Let me go ahead and check that out. What other pictures do we have? Hyrule Compendium. We got these things. Monsters, none. Creatures, no creatures. So really only gave me like those two mushrooms. And this right here, the cool Cephalina. No weapons. No treasures either. It'd be good to take a picture of the treasure then, because that could be really helpful. Anyways, we gotta get going. Finding the right way to get to where I wanna go might be the hard part. at this point. Look at these guys. These guys are cool. You got a doggy here. You got these cool cow things. You know, we gotta find Sky. Is Sky gonna be back down there? I really, really hope so. I'm gonna go ahead and try to find her. Sky, I'm coming. I'm coming, Sky. I should probably just teleport one of those shrines and try to find out. I really doubt she'll be there, but I'll be the happiest zebra if she is. Because that means I could just pick her up and register her and then probably always be able to find her. I can only assume at that point. This place is beautiful during the nighttime, though. I love it. Let's get down there. Come on, come on. Let's get on down. Come on, come on. Let's get on down and find my horse. There is a... Is it Sky? There she is! She's been here waiting for me the entire time! I love this game. This game knows me. It knows that I want my horse back. I'm happy. I don't know where to put you, though. Like, I don't know where would be the best place to bring you. Like, where is the stable at? The stable's a hop, skip, and a jump away. Right? I can't remember. Because we came in... Yeah, it's way over here. And bringing you up on the mountain might not be the easiest thing, but we gotta register you. I don't know though, because if you've always been here, I don't know. I'm having a hard time deciding. I think we just gotta make the trip. We gotta make the trip and register. It's worth it. It's totally worth it for sure. I just feel like I haven't been getting a ton done recently, but I feel like that one thing, that's an essence of the game, you know? Is that, it's okay, it's okay. There we go, aw. But hey, it's okay. Come on, relax. When she's shaking her head, that's when she's upset. You don't want to? It's okay. You don't want to go. She doesn't want to run right now. I think she's annoyed because it's raining. Hello. You're just running? It's raining. Are you guys need help again? Look at these dorks. They got stuck in the same situation as other. Well, I can see their health this time. Wait, what can? Why can I see their health? That's different. Why can't I? Is that like a Sheikah Slate feature? That's weird. I can see their health now. Get this up. If you guys give me free food for it, I won't complain though. I saved your butt. Hey, that was close. That was exciting, but a little, yeah, they're giving me free stuff again. And also like didn't save before, but we already did this. I don't know what happened to the other lady. She's just running around somewhere. My cat is playing with stuff. Nah, you gotta go calm down. I'm trying to record right now. All right, I gotta make it to the stable at the least. Hey, look, another horse rider. How you doing? Hope you're doing good. I don't know what you said. Well, I'm just gonna keep going, because I got places to be. It looks like there's actually something over here. Maybe we'll come back to that. Right now, I'm just focusing on getting to the stable, because we're right there. And then we're gonna figure out how we can actually claim the horse, because I'm not really sure at the moment. But she can jump, right? She can't jump. I don't know how you can get your horse to jump, if you even can. Or maybe that'd be a little overpowered, and they don't want that. Not really sure. Come on, just keep going. I gotta calm her down a little bit. I'm sorry! Stay right here, okay? Please. All right, I'm gonna go over here. Hey, dude, how you doing? Go into our stable. If you've come with a wild horse, you can register us with us here. So what it'll be, register horse, gotcha. Yeah? You sure it's this one? Yeah, that's the one that's right there, right? That's Sky. I don't care, like, what its stats are, what the stats are. Not a problem. We charge a registration fee. The fee also gets you a locally made saddle and bridle for your horse. The fee is, oh, that's totally cool. That's fine. I thought it was gonna be like way too expensive. Please enter a name for your horse. Oh, we already got one. We already got one, ladies and gentlemen. There we go. Yes. Your registration is complete. Would you like to, take your new horse with you? Take horse. Thank you, we'll see you next time. Oh, and by the way, if you get separated from your horse, you can whistle and it will come running. Ah! But your horse isn't magic, it can't hear you if you're too far away, so keep that in mind. Yeah, but what happens if I, like, lose my horse? Over here. I love it! So what can I tell you? Hey, I lost my horse. Welcome. How can I help? Take horse? Hold on. So you're not, oh, okay, anything else? Board horse, so I can give you Sky. You wanna board Sky? Board horse. All right, we'll take Sky into our care, wait right here. Cool. Your horse is in our care, anything else? Bye-bye. All right, we'll be here if you need us. I'm so happy right now! Now we can actually go and do this actual quest. All right, so I'm gonna stay at the inn at the Hitino village just because it's raining. I'm gonna try to sleep till the next day. 20 rupees is a lot though. Regular bed, please. I don't really need the extra soft one, regular bed, one guest. When would you like to be morning? Please enjoy your stay. Thank you. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. I just really don't want it to be raining anymore. This is my thing. So hopefully we can wake up and not be raining because I gotta climb this mountain and that's gonna be a big pain in the butt if it's raining. So hopefully it's not. Good morning. Did you sleep well? Come back again soon. Cool. You don't give me like any amenities, not like food or anything? Fine. Maybe we should just take that, the lid, that pot over there. So it's not raining anymore, but it is quite damp out. I wonder if that still affects the mountains. I'm gonna hope it doesn't. Ooh, lizard, 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 gotcha. Hot-tail lizard. That lizard tried to hot-tail it out of here. Not happening though, buddy. Not happening. So I wonder if I go to any stable, will I be able to find Sky, or is it that one specific stable? That actually might be an issue, but there is a shrine right next to it, so that, you know, it works out either which way. Yeah, we're climbing up here now, because it's still way over somewhere, like way over here. It's not even like on this mountain, it's over it. So I'm hoping this is the best way to tackle it, but I'm honestly not entirely sure. We just sort of have to wing it because I don't have any towers. So maybe I should focus on getting a tower in that area. I just figured the best way to do that right now is to climb over this mountain and get it the best view possible. If I get too cold, I'm gonna have to put on my warm doublet again, but I'm not too worried about that. So it's fine. I wonder if, I'm guessing I could probably get some kind of cool Korok seed if I could light up every torch in the land. I'm sure that would get me like some kind of cool Korok seed. I can only imagine. Now this might be a little bit of a challenge to climb. There is a goat up here though. The goat can climb and I can too. I'm Link, I'm the hero of Hyrule. Look at him go. It's cool because like in real life, goats are good at climbing like that. It's crazy, like they could climb this. Goats are pretty impressive. It's almost like all four-legged hooved animals are amazing. Okay, hold on, it's cold. Let me quickly, he's all shivering. Here, that should keep you warmer, right? Warm enough, right? You're still too cold? Hold on, with the warm doublet, this air has become very cold. Yeah, I know, but am I still too cold? I am still too cold for this area. Just barely, but I think I am, yeah. So maybe I could finally, once I get a little low, I'll go ahead and eat, unless I already have. No, Dre, the spicy meat, 3 minutes, I'll have 3 minutes worth of that. It might be worth doing, of course, because the warm doublet's not enough, holy cow. This might be the worst decision yet then. I gotta get out of this area very soon then. I feel like the best way to do that would be to climb something and get out that way. And I also run slower here, I think. Man, this whole game is really starting to get tough. Luckily, like it isn't hurting me as much as if I didn't have the warm doublet at all, which is good. And I do have it equipped, right? Yeah, I definitely have it equipped. He's just shivering. It's sort of funny. At the same time, it's sort of sad. I'm gonna wait until I get one heart and then I'll go ahead and get some heals. But is it gonna be cold all the way through or just on this mountaintop? I really hope it's just on this mountaintop. Ooh, I don't know, it looks like it's cold all the way through. Anyways, doesn't really matter too much because as long as I get this, I hope this plus the warm doublet will be enough. Delicious! Okay, and oh yeah, it does actually help significantly. So let me try to see. We're way up here. I could try to climb up there, but it won't land. I won't be able to get there in 3 minutes. So I need to sort of rethink my plan. And I think right now it'll be to fly over to like this mountain and find out what I can get from that mountain. Like if I can get something good going on there, that's what I really want. But I don't really know what we'll find in this, you know, finding these old shrine thingies. I feel like I should spend more time in this icy area if I just ate that, but I don't know. I guess it doesn't really matter too much. No, I used what I could when I could. And that's what matters at the end of the day. I definitely want to get to the top of that though. That looks like it's gonna be fun to get to. But it looks like there's something over here. Sort of. Oh, it's another one of these brick puzzles. What is this one gonna be? Oh, I seen. This one actually doesn't look too bad. I think what I gotta do is I have to, pick this up. No, I missed. I can't believe I missed that. And I gotta put it right here. Yep, there you go. These really aren't too bad. Like most of these are pretty easy. Once you spot them, you know them. Aha, you found me. Good job, there's our Korok seed. Six, nice. Okay. Just trying to find out where to go from here. Like, if I could find another tower, well, I'm not gonna find a tower here, but I'm trying to find like a height advantage so I know where to get to my next tower, which is why I wanna go up the top of this giganto mountain. So I think it's the best choice. What is that thing? What in the, oh, it's a goat. I don't know why, but I looked at it backwards. It looked like a weird scorpion with a spiky tail. I was like, what? This is not the right biome for a scorpion thing. It's not the desert. But man, oh man, I can't tell if it's cold over there or not. It is, I think. So maybe we can't even do that one at all. Like, I don't know, this is really tough. All right, I'm finally at the top. Oh, look at this rock. This is definitely another croc seed. Yep, that one was easy. Hey, it's got little berries. Haha, you found me. That's another croc seed. So I'm getting a lot of those. Oh, I dropped it on him again. Keep doing that to these guys. So there is another tower right over there. The problem is it isn't a cold area, so I only have a few options. But you can tell that there's actually a lot of things of interest around here. That is a like a dam. Pretty cool. Is that the tower I want? No, this right here is the tower I want. You can clearly see that it's like in the cold area. But I think I could probably get there and maybe climb up it and be able to deal with that before the cold actually kills me. Because it doesn't look too far into a cold area. Like, I can already see some green from here. So that'll be my today's episode's goal, is to get there and activate that and hopefully not die in the process. Who knows, this is crazy looking though. And there's like a whole thing down there. Not really sure what it's about, but still very, very cool. And I wonder if we'll ever get a paraglider upgrade, like a better one that can go farther and not eat up as much stamina. Like, I really hope that they like expand every aspect of this game. There, you know, if they're gonna make it so open, you know? Because that's like, I like its openness, and I've said this earlier, but it also sort of frustrates me because there's like times like this where this is what I think I wanna do and I think it might be the best action, but I honestly don't know. Like, maybe I should be spending way more of my time finding memories, but that just doesn't seem right. Like, obviously the memories are important, but I can't get to the one by Hyrule, and I really don't know the location of any of the other ones because I need to explore the game more. Maybe I should spend some time on side questing, but I feel like, you know, side questing is usually just that, side questing. Can I like move these? Oh, these make like a, ooh, I see what I need to do. This is another one. Stop time, let me go ahead and, do I still have that big old hammer? I do. Here, boom, if I hit this out of the circle of rocks, I think this is gonna get me a Korok seed. Let's see. No? Look at it though. No, it's supposed to go here. Whoops. I thought I was, I'm so dumb. I hope that comes back at some point because that rock is gone. I thought the entire circle was already completed. I'm such a dingle butt. A butt of dingle, that's what I am. Where'd it go? It's still here. I think I need to like mark it on my map. So I might have to like mess with my map a little bit to get rid of some of my waypoints because I have a lot of them. Like I'll get rid of this one, I guess, delete pin. Maybe I should have changed it to a stamp. I'll just put a stamp here. That way I can go here. And boop. Okay. Let's do this. Once again, like it's barely into the cold area. So as long as I can get across that river and then up it, I think I'll have enough food to last me. Like, I don't think that's gonna be a big issue. It's just a matter of getting there. Having a good time doing it too. Having a good old time. Mm-mm-mm, good. Bye birds, bye birds. I don't know if like those birds you can actually take out. These smaller ones, I can't imagine that you could. There's even a little fire over here. We might be able to find some cool stuff. The thing I worry about is, you know, the closer we are to Hyrule Castle, the stronger things happen to be. Which worries me a lot. You would think that like Hyrule Castle would be the farthest point from where you start the game, but that's actually not the case at all. It's actually relatively close if you compare it to everything else. Like Hyrule Castle's like here. It's like not even close to the farthest point in the game. A wanderer, he's just watching me in the air. Look at that wanderer. Hello.
Yeah.
Oh, so you heard me humming, huh? No, I didn't. I'm Eric. I'm traveling the world on a journey of self-discovery. I'm heading to Zora's domain now, but I'm lost. I was just about to give up, but then like, I heard a voice coming from the North Tower. Crossing the Rutala River would be next to impossible though. Zora's domain? Zora's domain is the home of Zora. It's a town in the Nairu, but crossing the Rutala River is impossible. It's hard, it's a hard place to get to, so I just gave up altogether. Is there something you could else you'd like to ask me? North Tower. If you continue north from here, on the other side of the Rutala River, you can see a huge tower on the opposite bank. I thought I heard a voice coming from the top of the tower. I wonder if someone's up there. Is there anything else you had to do? Rutala River. Rutala River is the wildest river in Lunairu. You'd be risking your life if you tried to swim across it. If you want to go north of it, you'll have to walk patiently to Lineback Island in the east so you can circumvent it. Is there something else? Nope, that's gonna be it, thank you. See ya. So what tower, north of here? I think he means this tower. Cause this is where I gotta be. I'm really not that, I think we're almost at the Zora place, which is good. But if we go north from here, pick up some iron shrooms while I'm doing that. That is a loud bird, oh my gosh. What is in here? Little cave, what's in here? Little cave, not much at all. There's a little cut through. I hear one of those dude guys though. I think I hear a Korok. Oh, yep, there's that up there. Let's go ahead and try this one then. What is this one? Oh my. Oh, this is gonna be tough. I only have one arrow. Oh no, you know what I can do then? Let me be crafty with this. And hope that this works. It might be a little too far out of my range. I think they specifically made it like that. Ready? Yep. Oh yeah, I messed that up. I'll try this, but I don't think I'm gonna be able to do it this way. Yep. I didn't get it. Okay, one last shot. I'll try stasis. And then we'll try to like stop them. Hold on. Oh, I almost got it. I can get it for sure. Yes. Okay, so I'll definitely be able to hit this one. Will that break it though? I hope so. No, it didn't break it. We did it. I have no idea if that actually broke it or not. Oh gosh, this is funny. That might be a little too far, but I can throw this. Oh no, it's way too far. Oh, I don't want to waste a fire arrow, but I have to. Hold on. I got it. Does that count? Hey, it counts, nice. There you go, I got both of them one way or another. You found me. Give me that Korok seed. Maybe a little too much effort than it was worth, but hey, you did it. Whee, let's go. Let's go. Look at all these deer. Beautiful. I love this game, it's so visually pleasing. Okay, let me go ahead and pick that up as well. It's a helium shroom, we've got plenty of them, we'll have plenty more. There it is, and this is that river he was going on about. Apparently uncrossable. The rifts are too strong. There's gigantic rib cages over there. Honestly, it doesn't look like there's a, maybe this isn't it. Maybe there's another tower. Because honestly, this doesn't look so bad. Especially since you can see there are some small crossing areas. I don't think this is what he's talking about. Either way, I'm hopping down here. Wish it wasn't gonna rain, but I need to learn how to look ahead on the weather. Like that is definitely a good lesson to learn. Because this happens a lot where I'm about to start climbing stuff and the weather gets bad. So if I could like look ahead of that, this is a lot of swamps around here though. If I could look ahead of that and try to make sure that I always like am a day or two ahead of, are that a bunch of keys? Oh my gosh, I think that's like a huge flock of keys flying around that tower. Either that or it's like a tree. Oh man, we gotta take a look at that. There's giant flocks of keys that we see before, just a teaser trailer to this. Maybe not, maybe those are leaves in the background. You think those are leaves in the background, it's not just an evil horde of keys. That would have been awful. Okay, that guy's gonna get got if I had what I need. Hold on, I got it. I missed. I need to stop wasting my fire arrows as much, apparently. I'm on fire. I'm on fire now. Here, hold on. I don't have a sword right now. Cause I threw my only torch. That's okay. Ooh, I'm just smacking you across the face and you won't do nothing. What is this? This is a highlight, or a high-tail lizard. Okay, I thought it was like a sword or something. Apparently not. Interesting that we've made our way across. In this episode, I'm gonna try to make it a little bit longer than normal. That can continue on and making progress and everything. I was hoping one of those guys would drop a sword or some kind of weapon. None of them? Neither of them had any weapons? Were they gonna punch me? I guess. Uh-oh. Whoa, look at him. Look at this big kahuna. I don't know, this is like a very heavily guarded area. I'm gonna go ahead and eat up some more apples because I have plenty of them. Oh, I don't have any more hearts. He doesn't seem to see me. Hold on. First, let's go ahead and throw. Wow, he's scary. Wow, he's really scary. Throw just like that. Can I like maybe just maybe? I can't stop you. No, I can't. Like it might like, oh jeez, he's huge. He's stinking ripped, bro. Oh, that really hurt. Okay, I might have to regret everything I've ever done in my entire life. Eat, chug. Oh boy, there he is. Hold on. That was probably a dumb idea because I'm gonna get on fire too. But he's freaking out. Ooh, I'm slicing and dicing him now. Ooh, he's gonna get gone. Oh, my sword's badly damaged. That hurt me a lot again. He hits me so hard for so much. Come on, eat. I really am probably unprepared for this area, but I don't know what to do. Come on, hold on. Let me, no, not what I wanted. Wow, he is swinging, look at him go. Ow, that almost hit me. Drop. That didn't hit him, come on. No, stop. Oh boy, he's a quick one. Drop. Gosh darn it, come on. Oh man, I just had to hit him once with my fire arrow and he's done for though. And that dude, he's donezo. Just like that. Get it, God. We got him. We took him out. Sometimes I wish there was experience in this game. Spiked Mocha or Moblin Club. Animal Bone has experience affixed to this Moblin damage to greatly improve damage. Okay, something like that. Very cool. I got myself some stuff. Oh man, that was a pain though. I don't know how longer I can keep up with this if that's what I'm gonna be running into here. I can only hope that's not the case though. I won't be running into that constantly. I'm gonna go ahead and try some of this stuff out. Boom, flint, salt, useful stuff. Amber, more amber, cool. All right, there's stuff everywhere. We got blue moblins. I don't like this. What is that thing? Oh my gosh, I need it. I don't know what he did, but you see how this game, like it'll tell you what you gotta deal with before you have to deal with it? Ooh, right in your face. And then I'm gonna go ahead and throw this at you quickly before other people can deal with you. You're gonna fall like that, and then you're gonna hop back up and be like, who did that? Oh geez, I got my last fire arrow here. And I took him out before he could alarm anybody else. The spike bokobo. Good fruit. What is this? This is a palm fruit. Fruit from palm trees that grows near the ocean. It doesn't offer any special effects, but will increase your heart recovery when used as an ingredient. But that guy had the really, really awesome ice shot. And that's something I could probably use. What is this? Luminous stone, this mysterious mineral gives off a pale blue glow in the dark, which some believe to be souls of the dead. Apparently this stone can be used as a base to make special clothing. Cool. I don't like the look of this. I don't like the look of this. I might have to come back, cause like, these guys are a bit too strong for my taste. What is going on up there though? If I could sneak up there, wait, what can I take? Oh, raw bird drumstick. This meat is tougher and chewier than standard meat, tastes better cooked. And we got raw meat. Very cool. It's getting nighttime though, so more dangerous baddies are gonna start popping up. I wonder if skeleton moblins are a thing. Why am I running out of stamina so quick? Ooh, ready, set, jump. Oh, good. I need to wait right here though. I'm slipping a little bit. Don't be tripping, Link. And all I need to do is sneak past. Oh, this is slippery. That is real slippery, bro. I just gotta do my best to make sure nobody notices me because I am just in unfriendly territory at the moment. Can you? Run! No, leave me alone, you big bully! Oh, there's a chest over there too. Okay, if I just keep moving, nobody has to find me. There's a lot of people. Wait, is there somebody up here? Uh-oh. 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 Hold on, hold on. Get out of here! Get! Yeah, see ya! See, that's my tower now, buddy. Okay. He's mad, but he's actually half health. So I'm gonna get you across to here, and I'm just gonna keep moving. I'm gonna move quick. Boom, get another one of these. And if they can't catch me, they can't hurt me. Oh, you can't hit what you can't. What in the world is that thing? What in the world? What is this, Adventure Time? What is that thing? I'm scared to go near it. He looks like he's nice, but he also looks like he's from Stinkin' Adventure Time or something. Also, I'm missing out on all these luminous stones. Amazing stuff. I am so nervous about it. I gotta save the game. Cause it's like, that guy looks harmless, but you never know. You never, ever know. Oh, there is this guy. All right, him I can tussle with. Hold on. Hey, you're gone. Oh, he's like running around. Hold on. Whoa. Yep. Oh, I can slice and dice you all day though. You're not a problem. Vocal club I can't pick up. Hey, I can see a shadow. Am I supposed to be fighting you? I don't know, he's cool. Oh, he's a bad guy. Oh, he's totally a bad guy. He is totally, totally, totally a bad guy. I'm running then. Like, I don't even know if I need you in my life right now. I wanna use a different weapon though. Since this is damage, I might just wanna throw that at you and then run over and then just beat you up like that. My broadsword broke, but I can just slap you with your own weapon, so whatever. And he's like raining it down. Can you stop, sir? Oh no, 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 no. Here, I gotta get more health. I'm running out of apples really quick. I need to start using real food. Ooh, that must have hurt. Is he down? Did I take him out? Ice key swing, cool. Ice rod, a magical rod crafted from refined ice found in the Hebra Mountains. This rod can cast waves of freezing air. Great for magic, not so great for melee. Wow, and I don't have enough, okay. Let's see, let's see. What can I drop right now? I'm gonna drop this, exchange it for that for some really obvious reasons. And there we go. All right, we're making some progress one way or another, and that's good to see. But now it's a matter of continually getting up there. Wait, is this the one I climbed earlier? No, this is a different one. What in the world is that thing? Okay, buddy, I didn't see you, you didn't see me. Leave me alone. I don't know what that thing is, but I don't care. Ooh, you don't see me though. Let me go ahead and get you on. Oh no, this. This thing is 27 damage. Woo-wee. Wrong button. If I sneak up, oh, come on. Drop, explode, where are you now? No, I knocked the tower down! No, the tower! It was gonna be so helpful. Where are you going, huh? Ready, jump, slam, I missed, but I still got him. Give me that wood at the least. Oh my gosh, oh my stinking gosh. It's starting to rain again. I wonder, like, can I start a fire? I mean, I can in the rain. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to climb this now. And it's a lightning storm too? Come on, I just wanna get to this tower. I'm just gonna use the cliffs of the rock as much as I physically can. We're at Lanayu Tower now. I really hope I don't get hit struck by lightning, because that would be the worst. And this guy's like mad creepy. Wow. Come on, jump. Jump! No, come on. Oh, this is bad. This is really bad. Oh, what am I supposed to do? I just wanna go home. I don't have a home. My home got taken by Ganon. I don't even have a home no more. I can't get up there. Oh no. And I can't just like sink and meditate. I could try to get, oh, I can't. I can't even, I'm just trying to get this one little ledge. So easy in any other situation. I just can't do it, come on. And just every time he jumps, he slips like crazy. Fine, I'm getting this stuff right here. This is actually a hassle. I don't know what to do about this one. Hi-ya. Ooh, ruby, a precious red gem mined from a large deposits found throughout Hyrule. Rubies contain the power of fire and have fetched high prices since ancient times. Cool. Oh, he attacked me! Rude! I don't like you, please leave me alone. Or did he attack me? Or am I getting electrocuted? One of the two. I'm really not sure. That worked! I'm a genius! I put wood down, I put flint down. I'm gonna sleep till morning. That actually worked! And I just slashed it with my sword. And I did it under, you know, the thing, so it worked. That is so cool. And I figured that out on my own. Oh man, I'm so happy now. The thing is, there's probably gonna be a lot of mocha blends or something waiting for me. I'm just gonna climb. As soon as I can, as quick as I can, I'm gonna climb up here and just get it done with. And if I can get more flint, because now I know the extreme value of flint. Boom, amber. That is so cool though. I'm so glad I figured that out all on my own and I didn't have to like run away or anything. Now when it comes to actually this tower, it looks like there's nothing touching the tower itself. It's just everything, the base around it. There were tons of evil guys. So now I can climb up this with hopefully not too much of an issue. That would be great, game. That would be great. So I'm just gonna wait here and then start climbing and climbing and climbing and climbing. Okay, hold on. Ooh. Let's restore stamina a little bit more. I just gotta get to the top of it. What was that noise? So high up, whoa, what are you? Hello? He's a shark guy, whoa, wow! I cannot believe it! Excuse me, yes, you, I am Groob of the Zora. It is apparent that you are a traveler, but may I ask what brought you here? I could ask the same. How very astute of you. Oh no, I didn't read what that said. An excellent something. I, by order of Prince Sidon of Zor's domain, am searching for a Hylian. Or I was, but then I fell asleep. I awoke to a loud noise and awful quacking, and now here I am. I'd like to get down and be on my way, but simply I'm too high up. I need to figure something out. Princess Sidon is down at that bridge below, but for some reason, I'm burping. For some reason, I cannot seem to catch his attention. But you are a Hylian, yes, or Hylian? Well then, my luck is improving. Prince Sidon, I found one! I found a Hylian! Prince Sidon doesn't seem to notice my struggle. Perhaps I should allow or swallow my fear and jump from the to the river below. Then I can return to him. He must be worried sick. Nope, can't do it. I'm too high up. I'll luckily meet the gods of the ever after before I see Prince Sidon again. Mr. Hylian, I must apologize. It will be some time before I can get back to Prince Sidon. Please, you must leave me here and go on ahead. Sure thing. First off, let me figure out this tower. And I think that's what we're gonna be doing for today. I love the effect on the ground with the rain. That is super cool. Nice touch. There we go, we got another tower activated, which you know that means I'm gonna be able to see a lot more of this environment. The tower does its little beamy beam thing. It turns blue instead of orange and we are happier for it. Ooh, bada bing, bada boom. Nice. Okay, so there's a bit more of the map revealed. I wonder how much. I don't think a ton because there's like a lot of towers in this area. So I'm gonna guess it's not a ton, but that usually it seems like where there is more towers and less land revealed per tower, there's a lot of resources in, you know, like, I guess is value within that land. Like a lot more than a larger area. So let's see here. Actually, whoa, is it really gonna reveal? Holy cow, that's still a huge ton. I mean, most of it's ocean, but that's still a lot. A huge, wow, now we can really get a lot of context of what's going on down there. Regional map extracted. Very, very cool. And I think that's probably where we're gonna be finishing things up today. In a moment, I mean, in the next episode, we'll go ahead and talk to Woods, who's its flop down there, and sort of talk to his pal, whoever he's talking about, because at this point, I'm completely confused. Me and you, Groove, me and you, we're gonna figure out something, take over the world. But for now, thank you guys so much for watching today's episode of The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to give this video a like, share with your friends and family, and of course, comment in the comment section below. If you watched this one video, make sure you comment Zebra Horse on it you've watched the video and that you are a Zebratastic viewer. But either way, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.